Good afternoon. Here's the latest update on Hurricane Matthew. Still a strong Category 3 storm, a major hurricane. Winds of 120 miles per hour, gust of 145, moving to the northwest at 12 miles per hour. On this track, it is going to finish crossing over the Bahamas as we go through the day today, possibly strengthening even more to a Category 4 storm by tomorrow morning, and then either making a very close brush with Florida or making landfall with the Space Coast and then bending back to the north and east. Some models take this storm out to sea. Others, get this, bring it back around and hit Florida for a second time. So it's something to watch over the next several days. What does this mean for you, though? So when you take a hurricane right inside that center eye wall, that's where you're going to have the strongest winds, right around that center cluster of thunderstorms. That's where we have the 120 mile per hour winds. Once you fan the storm out, the winds start to get a little bit less and less. With this particular hurricane, the hurricane winds extend about 45 miles from the center, and then tropical storm force winds extend nearly 200 miles from the center. So when you're looking at the track of this, if this storm tracks right down the middle, if it brushes that coast and stays a little bit offshore, you are going to have slightly weaker winds than, say, if this storm pushed on shore. That's when you could have catastrophic 120 mile per hour winds plus onshore with all of the storm surge, as well as the very, very heavy rainfall. Best case scenario, it stays to the east side of the cone, stays offshore, and the winds aren't quite as great. You'll still get high surf, beach erosion, but you won't have those strong hurricane force winds. If this storm, once again, though, tracks right down the center line, we could see devastating winds, though, across much of the coast of Florida, as well as storm surge, a lot of rainfall, and beach erosion. Something to watch very closely over the next couple of days.